How are you, Mr. Barbario?
Good, yourself?
Yeah, not bad at all. That was a nice one, eh?
Yeah, it was a good game. We played really hard as a team, and it was nice to get that win.
Oh, gave me fits in the last 2.5 minutes. You got to stop that. I'm getting old.
There was a little bit of drama, but credit to the guys. We stuck to the game plan and did a good job of sticking to the systems and pulled out a win.
Mark, I thought it was interesting. It seemed to me from our point of view that the Wildcats owned the first period, Lewiston owned the second, and then I don't know what happened in the dressing room between the second and third period, but you guys came up like gangbusters in the third period.
Yeah, well, after the second period, we knew we had to come out strong for the third. Lewiston's a good team, so it was nice to come out hard, and there were some ups and downs that third, but it was nice to pull through.
In your wildest dreams, did you ever expect to score 5 goals against Jonathan Bernier?
We'll take any we can get, but he's a good goalie. He made some big saves, but we just went to the net hard, and we executed. We made good plays, and that led to goals.
It seems, guys, you seem to feed off certain plays, and I thought Bernier made a tremendous save in the second period there, with the first period with the trapper there, and I just shook my head and wondered, how he got across that quickly, and it seemed to shift the momentum a bit. Does that happen often? Is that something that you're aware of?
Well, hockey's a game of momentum, so anytime a big save is made or a big hit or a nice play, it tends to shift the momentum of the game, but it's how you deal with that, and try not to get too high with the highs, too low with the lows, and just go about your business in a calm, even-like manner and get the job done.
What were you thinking, Mark? I've got to ask you, because Bernier was out, I think, for a minute and 8 seconds, was it? They had the empty net. What were you thinking when you're down, you're up by a goal, you see the goaltender go to the bench? What goes through your head?
Well, biggest thing is, the defensive zone. You want to take care of the slot and make sure the puck gets out. You don't want to think too much about that empty net and getting that goal unless you cross the red line. But your first priority is obviously defense.
Mm-hmm. So it's not score the goal.
No, only if you cross the red line. But unless you're Scott Brandon, you don't really think about scoring there. Hopefully, Scott doesn't see that.
That's why you guys come out here, Jay Leno will never run out of comedy writers. These guys give up hockey. Absolutely amazing. You're one of the key guys in a situation like that, though, when it comes down to that kind of drama at the end of the game with an empty net. Are you thinking the same thing Mark is thinking?
Well, it's obviously defense first and making sure pucks get out of your zone, get over the red line, and obviously, you tend to think a little bit about the fact the net's empty when you're out there, especially as a forward. But it's a defense first, and take care of your own zone. And if you cross the red line, then you start to think about getting that empty net a little bit.
I was impressed with the grit in the last 40 seconds or so, and then with the face-off in the Wildcat zone on the icing. You start wondering, oh my God, we're down to 19 seconds. What's going to happen? That's what I think. I'm always interested in what the players think when they see something like that happen.
Well, we have a lot of confidence in our guys, especially that third line of ours. Sill, Brandon, Morehouse, they did a good job. Guys like that, just honest, hard two-way guys. Guy like Matty Brenton tonight stepped up, 2 big goals for us. Big momentum in the first half of the game to get us going. So we got a lot of confidence when we get to that situation, especially if there's a face-off, that Zach can go out there and do the job. And it's all about confidence, I guess.
Okay. Mark, I want to ask you about the power play, because you and David Savard spent a lot of time tonight on the power play. And I thought the way you set it up, the crisscross plays were really working well, and it seemed that you were the go-to guy for the shot.
Well, it's not just me being the go-to guy for the shot. You got David there, new addition on the team, and he's just got unbelievable shots. So, any one of us can take a shot out there, and you're not just looking for one guy. You're just looking for the best play available on the power play. And sometimes it's the shot, sometimes the pass down low. And, Whatever's open is what you take.
Do you see the angle though when you're in that situation and you get the pass, and you move in a stride or two strides from the blue line, do you sometimes see an opening, an angle, a chance?
Yeah, I do sometimes, but I find when I concentrate too much, I'm trying to pick one corner, I end up missing the neck completely. So no, most of my goals or shots I get rebounds are just... I'm not really looking, I'm just trying to make sure it hits the net, you know, because once I concentrate too much, I end up screwing up.
Nobody wants you to screw up, Margaret. The other thing, Matt, you, it seemed to me tonight the power play was much more effective than in the last couple of games we've seen. You were cycling in the corner all the time, and I mean, it seemed to me you were moving more tonight from your position over on the far wing.
Well, we worked on changing formations, trying to go from an umbrella to a box plus one. We had a lot of success with the box plus one earlier in the year, and the team started to catch on a little bit. And you know, it obviously makes things a little harder when teams start to read what you're doing. So, I think when we changed formations and you know, showed them two different looks, especially on our units, it you know, it gave us a little more room to operate once we wanted to do our set plays.
And you sent in the second power play unit tonight. Browning was out there doing his thing.
Yeah, Brownie played a great game for us. You know, scored that big goal at the end there, and might not have been a pretty one, but you know, we'll take them as they come, especially against Bernier. So he played a great game, made some good plays on both of Branson's goals, and got the big one there at the end. You know, proved to be the winner.
Well, that really made it worthwhile. Final question from me, and then we'll throw it open for the folks. But Mark, it's been an up and down season. I think the count now is 17 losses by one goal. Do you have nightmares about that?
Well, no. I mean, the fact that we're in every game is a great sign. I mean, if we were getting blown out 6-1, 5-1, or whatever like that, then you would start to have nightmares. But you know, if you lose by one goal, you know that you can have confidence knowing that you're in every game, and that any team you face up against, you have a chance to win.
How do you explain last night up in Rouyn-Noranda with Halifax and the Huskies? My goodness.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, geez, like Rouyn-Noranda's got an explosive team, so you know, they got a lot of offense and firepower. So 12 goals, it seems like a lot, but they're a team that can do it.
It blew me away. I'm looking at the internet and I'm saying, I don't believe this.
Yeah, when those two teams play, there's going to be a lot of goals scored because they're both kind of run and gun teams, like to open it up, and you know, it could go one way one time, one way the other time, because there's a lot of firepower between those two squads.
Yeah.